In this video, I'm going to complete numbers 10 through 15 of the Solving Inequalities, or Multi-Step Inequalities, free worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Algebra 2 section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Picking up where we left off in the first video, number 10. I'm going to start by distributing negative 2 to the b and to 1, and there's addition in between those two terms. So I'll have negative 2b plus negative 2 times 1 is negative 2, plus 4 is going to be less than 10. Now I'm going to combine my like terms, which is negative 2 and 4. So I'll have negative 2b plus negative 2 plus 4 is going to be a positive 2, and that's less than 10. Next, I'll subtract 2 from both sides in order to isolate the term with the b. So I'll have negative 2b on the left-hand side of my inequality, and that's going to be less than 10 minus 2, which is a positive 8. My next step is to divide both sides by negative 2. Remember, since I'm dividing by a negative, I'm going to have to switch the inequality sign. So, since it's less than here, it's going to become greater than. So that'll be b is greater than 8 divided by negative 2, which is negative 4. Now, when graphing this, I'm going to find negative 4, and I'm going to circle it. B cannot be equal to it, so I'm not going to shade it in. However, b is greater than negative 4, and greater than will be everything to the right of negative 4. Let's move on to number 11. On number 11, a minus 15 is greater than negative 4 times negative 6 plus 3a. I'm going to start by distributing negative 4. That's going to give me that a minus 15 is greater than negative 4 times negative 6 is a positive 24, plus negative 4 times 3a is negative 12a. I want to move all my terms with a to the left-hand side of my inequality. So I'm going to add 12a to both sides. A plus 12a will be 13a, and I'm still subtracting 15 from that, and that quantity is greater than 24. Next, in order to isolate my term with my a, I'm going to add 15 to both sides. So I'll have 13a is greater than 24 plus 15, which is 39. Finally, I'll divide both sides by 13. 13 divided by 13 is 1, a times 1 is a, 39 divided by 13 is going to be 3. So a is greater than 3 in number 11. So I'm going to circle the 3, however I'm not shading it in, but I'll shade everything to the right since a is greater than 3. In number 12, I'll start by distributing the 3. The 3 will be multiplied to the 6b and multiplied to the 1 with subtraction in between those. So I'll have 3 times 6b, which is a positive 18b, minus 3 times 1, which is 3. That is going to be greater than 18 minus 3b. Moving my terms with my variable to the left-hand side, I'm going to add 3b to both sides. 18b plus 3b is 21b. I'm still subtracting 3, and that's greater than 18, since 18 minus 3b plus 3b is 18 plus 0, which is 18. Then I'll add 3 to both sides to get the 21b all by itself, and that's going to be greater than 18 plus 3, which is 21. Next, I'll divide both sides by 21 to get that b is greater than 21 divided by 21, which is 1. So knowing that b is greater than 1, I'll find 1 on the number line, circle it, and then shade everything to the right. Let's move on to number 13. For number 13, I'll start by distributing the 5. So I'll get 26 plus m is greater than or equal to 5 times negative 6, which is negative 30, plus 5 times 3m, which is 15m. My next step, I'm going to subtract m from both sides. Continuing my work beneath my number line, I'll get that 26 is greater than or equal to negative 30 plus 15m minus m is 14m. Then I'll add 30 to both sides. That'll give me that 56 is greater than or equal to 14m. Dividing both sides by 14, 56 divided by 14 is 4, and that's going to be greater than or equal to m, which I can rewrite as m is less than or equal to 4. Since if 4 is greater than or equal to m, then m is less than or equal to 4. Knowing this, I can now plot my inequality. So I'll circle 4 and I will fill it in. Since m can be equal to 4, and I'm also going to shade everything to the left, since m is less than or equal to 4. In number 14, I'll start by distributing negative 2. So I'll get that 20 minus 2p is greater than negative 2 times p, which is negative 2p, plus negative 2 times 2, which is negative 4, plus 4p. Then I'll combine my like terms. I'll combine negative 2p and 4p together. At the same time, I'll also add 4 to both sides. That way my 4s will cancel out on my right hand side of my inequality, and I'll get 20 plus 4, which is 24. Then I'm still subtracting 2p, and that is going to be greater than negative 2p plus 4p, which is positive 2p. My next step, I'm going to add 2p to both sides of my inequality. And doing this, 2p will cancel out on the left hand side, and I'll get that 24 is greater than 2p plus 2p, which is 4p. Continuing my work over here, knowing that 24 is greater than 4p, all I have to do is divide by 4 to get that 6 is greater than p, which we could also say p is less than 6. I'll circle the 6, however I will not fill it in, and I'll shade everything to the left since p is less than 6. Now on to number 15. X plus 1 plus 1 plus 6x is greater than 3 times x minus 4 minus x minus 4. Now there are multiple ways to get started on this. Let me just show you one of those ways. I'm going to start by combining my like terms on my left-hand side of my equation. That's going to be my 1 and 1, and it's also going to be my x and 6x. Also notice that x minus 4 is the same as x minus 4. So 3 times x minus 4 minus 1 times x minus 4, I can also think of these as like terms and combine those. So x plus 6x will be 7x plus 1 plus 1, which is 2. That takes care of my left-hand side, and that's going to be greater than 3 times x minus 4 minus 1 times x minus 4, which will leave me with 2 times x minus 4. And if that confuses you for a second, think of x minus 4 as a variable. Let's say y. We know that 3y minus 1y is 2y, and since y represents x minus 4, 2y is the same as 2 times x minus 4. Now we're going to distribute the 2. We'll get that 7x plus 2 is greater than 2 times x, which is 2x, minus 2 times 4, which is 8. Now I'm going to move all my terms with x to the left-hand side. So I'm going to subtract 2x from both sides. And doing this, my 2x's will cancel out on the right. At the same time, I'm going to subtract 2 from both sides. Doing this, my 2's will cancel out on the left. Therefore, my terms with my variable are all alone on the left-hand side, and my terms without are all alone on the right. 7x minus 2x is 5x, and that is greater than negative 8 minus 2, which is negative 10. So rewriting this, I have that 5x is greater than negative 10. So I'm going to divide both sides by 5 to get that x is greater than negative 2. So now that I've simplified my inequality, I'm going to go ahead and plot that. So I'll circle negative 2, and I know that x is greater than negative 2, so I'm not shading in the negative 2, but I'm shading in everything to the right. So for number 15, x is greater than negative 2. And I'm going to stop this video here now that I've completed number 15. Join me in the next video where I'll go over numbers 16 through 22, finishing out the multi-step inequalities worksheet. And as always, if you have any comments, please feel free to leave them below. And also, don't forget to click that thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel. Doing each of those lets me know that you're finding these videos helpful and encourages me to make more videos for you.